Simon Fitzgerald, neighbor.
I'm glad you've come to talk. There's a lot to be heard over the fence. As his neighbor, I saw the day today, you know. Not to mention, I'm very perceptive. We live next door to each other, but quite differently, obviously. I teach history, being out of 32 years this August. Of course, this is about Ray, though. Private man, strange. He'd a way about him, I always felt. A peculiar kind of uncooperativeness. Not very neighbourly in a way that set me vigilant. Something about him seemed to try too much. Put on, you know. He'd rarely wave or mutter much to you. One of those people who had no balance between work and home. It always seemed contrived, which hardly fools me. I wasn't impressed, you know, but he was always touching up his car or looking after someone else's. And there was a faux benevolence to him too, then, I should say. Oh, he'd fix anybody's radio or television or car with a grunt. Oh, Ray was good about that. Assisting. Coming to the rescue when the machines broke down. And I remember him fixing up the car of one of the women. Of course, there was nothing now to lead me to believe anything rotten about the arrangement. But I remembered when it all came out, who Drahns was, and, of course, I connected the dots before anyone else, oh, yeah. Oh, he'd fix my vehicle, sure, oh, yeah, because it would have been odd taking it elsewhere, away from the neighbourhood. But I always gave it a good look over myself, you know, tapped the brakes before leaving. Saw himself following in the footsteps of the greats. We called him Caesar, my son and I. Oh, you can imagine the talk Luke, my son, gets when he tells the people who he grew up next to. He runs a hotel, very busy hotel in the city centre. And if you're back in Dublin, just ring me and he'll get you all set up, no problem at all. Meets a lot of interesting people, my son. Now, too old to play with Pete, the Ray boy. I don't think I would have let them pal around anyway, Drahns being the father he was. I'm not an overly affectionate man, but I have a visible love. Taught himself a bit taller because he drove a nice car, Ray. Only thing nice he had on the land, mind you. And you'd be sure to find him tinkering, altering, just to be better. Didn't ever see anything suspicious outright or sinister, barring the garage light on at all hours of the night sometimes. He'd be in there too, smoking. Now, it'd only be a late night glance. You know, I'd be getting a glass of water, but he'd be in the garage at odd hours. You know, with the height of the windows and their slant, see, I could only make out that he was smoking, alone, I assumed. I'd think, there's Caesar in there with his black hearse smoking. Now, it didn't really look like a hearse, but it was a big black car. I'd always said that for years too, so don't think I'm making light of the murders. Just that he had a shiny black car and kept to himself.